Hello, in today's episode we are going to talk about Ouranosaurus. If you are enjoying our content, please leave a like and subscribe to our channel. Don't forget to click the bell to be notified about our future releases. Ouranosaurus is a genus of herbivorous basal hadrosauriform dinosaur that lived during the action stage of the early Cretaceous, about 110 to 120 million years ago. It lived in the area of modern-day Niger and Cameroon. It belongs to a group of dinosaurs called hadrosauriforms, also known as duckbill dinosaurs. Ouranosaurus appears to represent an early specialized branch in this group, showing in some traits independent convergence with the hadrosaurids. The name is a combination of the Arabic word for courage and the country of discovery, although Ouran is also the Tuareg name for the desert monitor. Ouranosaurus was a relatively large iguanodontian, estimated by Takei in 1976 to have a body length of 7 meters and a weight of 4 tons. A lighter weight of 2.2 tons was suggested by American paleontologist Gregory S. Paul in 2010 due to the leaner build observed in the animal compared to relation, although a longer length of 8.3 meters was given. Even the lower estimates were still outsized even the largest of the elephants. The holotype and paratype specimens were suggested to belong to subadults, although they would have been close to adult size. Paratype is 6.5 meters long as mounted, although a few caudals are missing, and is roughly 90% the length of the holotype, which would be 7.22 meters long. The variation between the sizes fits within the range of variation between adult individuals of iguanodon, so there is a chance that the larger holotype and smaller paratype were same ontogenetic stage. The most conspicuous feature of Ouranosaurus is a large sail on its back, supported by long, wide, neural spines, that spanned its entire rump and tail, resembling that of Spinosaurus, a well-known meat-eating dinosaur also known from northern Africa. These tall neural spines did not closely resemble those of sailbacks, such as Dimetrodon of the Permian period. The supporting spines in a sailback become thinner distally, whereas in Ouranosaurus the spines actually become thicker distally and flatten. The posterior spines were also bound together by ossified tendons, which stiffened the back. Finally, the spine length peaks over the forelimbs. The dorsal sail is usually explained as either functioning as a system for thermoregulation or a display structure. An alternative hypothesis is that the back might have carried a hump consisting of muscle tissue or fat, resembling that of a bison or camel, rather than a sail. It could have been used for energy storage to survive a lean season. First and only fossils of Ouranosaurus were discovered in 1965, in the Elras formation of the Tagama group, which was deposited during the action stage of the early Cretaceous. During this expedition, 8 iguanodontian specimens were discovered, two of which were Ouranosaurus. Both skeletons were mostly complete, missing some skull parts, fingers, and entire vertebral column. No additional fossils were found, meaning those two skeletons became holotype and paratype of Ouranosaurus. But the skeleton shared features with other iguanodontian specimens, particularly the opposable thumb ended with a spike-like claw, which was probably used as a defensive weapon. The jaws were apparently operated by relatively weak muscles. The back of the skull was rather narrow and could not compensate for the lack of a greater area of attachment for the jaw muscle that the openings normally would provide, allowing for more power and a stronger bite. A lesser muscle, the musculus depressor mandibuli, used to open the lower jaws, was located at the back of the skull and was connected to a strongly projecting, broad and anteriorly oblique lower jaw opening muscles. Ouranosaurus probably used its teeth to chew up tough plant food. A diet has been suggested of leaves, fruit, and seeds as the chewing would allow to free more energy from high-quality food. The wide beak on the other hand indicates a specialization in eating large amounts of low-quality fodder.